people asking me why they should be wearing a sunscreen on a daily basis. So today I thought, let me tell you what actually happens in the skin. With my skin model I have here, the top section here we have is called the epidermis, and the bottom section here we have is called the dermis. Now, when you are exposed to the sun, you have UVA rays that literally goes through the epidermis into your dermis. So those are very long rays and they go deep into the skin, affecting your collagen, your elastin, and also your jelly-like substance called hyaluronic acid or glycoaminoglycans. Then if we look at the UVB ray, which is a shorter ray than the UVA, that only goes into the epidermis. This is often the ray that affects the pigmentation, making you go darker. Also the ray that actually causes the burning of the skin. And then the theory is that UVC ray should be blocked up by the ozone layer, and if so, very short ray should not be really be reaching us. However, the UVA ray we find is around all year. So the minute there's light, there's daylight, there's UVA. So that means if every day you go out and you don't have any sun protection, you are getting aged on a daily basis. And that's why in a country like South Africa, where we have a lot of sun, we're actually a very old-looking nation because we're exposed to this all the time. Whereas the UVB that only goes into the epidermis, that really, as I mentioned before, only affects the pigment. So that's the one that could cause hyperpigmentation in your skin. But that's also the ray that's actually blocked out in winter months. And that's why you don't really feel the burning sensation in the winter as such. So sunscreen every single day is vital, because as the UV ray goes into the skin, it creates a lot of free radical damage in the skin, which eventually causes obviously scaffolding damage to our skin. But then of course there's also with the free radicals, if there's a lot of sun damage and DNA damage to your skin cells, that could lead to skin cancer. And often I see people coming through here that's had big pieces of skin cancer cut out on their nose, that maybe's had their nose reconstructed, or pieces of skin cancer cut out somewhere on their body. So for me, it is not negotiable. A sunscreen, at least a minimum of SPF 15. I use an SPF of 50 every single day on my skin, which really protects your skin. So if you can only afford one skincare product, let that be a good quality sun protection factor. And that for me is still the best anti-aging skincare product that you can invest in.